My white iPhone 11 Pro Max alarm clock wakes me out of my slumber with my Dua Lipa ringtone at approximately 8 a.m. Every night before I fall asleep, I always say I'll wake up early and start my day fresh. That never happens. I crawl back into my comfy white sheets and attempt to continue my daily morning dream about Tom Holland giving me an inspiring pep talk about my future.
You got this. Grab this day by the balls,
Tom Holland says. I totally agree with you, Tom. I nod and smile. I'm awoken yet again, this time by Ariana Grande. Most of my morning alarms have different ringtones. I'm awful at being organized. I rub my eyes to get all of the disgusting debris out of the inner corners and begin to stretch my arms to the sky to feel any sort of spark in my body before I begin my morning. Before I actually move or do anything remotely productive, I grab my cellular device and scroll. Twitter's what I spend most of my time on. There's no hot people to make me want to throw my phone at the wall and fall back to sleep. It's just filled with humor and vibes. God damn it, I think to myself when I scroll past a viral 4-photo set tweet of Hunter Schafer's new photo shoot. Never mind. Hot people surround every social media app. I move to my text messages to find only one morning text from my mom saying, "Are you awake?" I don't know, Mom. Physically? I guess so. Mentally? Not even close, I say in my head. I'm still too dead inside to inhale the energy to actually text back. The next 30 minutes are followed by me continuously dozing off and stretching my body out as far as I can while letting out a big groan. I lay in despair wondering, is it worth it today? I am so comfy right now. I could just stay here with my 8 hotel style pillows. I finally decide to rise out of bed to meet all of the items on my dresser next to me. I grab my vanilla bean chapstick first as my lips are quite dry from all the dream talking with Tom. When I apply my lip balm, I immediately feel 50 times better. I look in the mirror across the room as I smear the soft vanilla chapstick across my lips to see how my hair survived through the night. Sometimes it's worse than others. Today it wasn't too awful. Thank God. I stumble over back to my dresser to grab my essential water to hydrate for the wondrous Thursday to come. I heard hydrating in the morning is good for you or something. After I swallow the H2O to let it cleanse through my body, I turn around to realize my phone is lost. Where is my silly phone? I wonder. I quickly grasp my Arizona Cardinals blanket off my bed to find my phone hiding beneath. I grab my phone and head towards the bathroom to officially start my day. It's March. I should probably take this Christmas decoration that has been on my door handle for 2 years down, I think to myself as I walk through my basement to arrive to my bathroom. As I flick the light switch on, I look down and notice that my shirt is covered in forest green flurries from the comfy hoodie I've been wearing for the last 3 days. I then waddle over to my toilet to do my morning urination. It feels quite incredible to release yourself after a 12-hour night of not peeing because you're obviously sleeping. I flush my toilet and waddle back to my original spot directly in front of the mirror, and I start brushing my teeth. With my bamboo toothbrush and Colgate white toothpaste, scrubbing my choppers is a grand old time. I only use the red tube of Colgate toothpaste. Everything else is rancid and gross. When I brush my teeth, I also brush my lips, because I read somewhere that it exfoliates them. It kind of works, I guess. Then I obviously brush my tongue, because I would rather never have a good day on this earth again than have a white moldy looking tongue. A fresh pink tongue is worth the gagging pain that brushing my tongue causes. I flip back and wipe the leftover water off my freshly exfoliated lips, and I start to notice how fresh and clear my skin looks in the mirror. Damn, my skin looks really good, I say to myself excitedly. Looking at myself in the mirror brought me deja vu of last night, when I was doing the exact same thing while doing my nightly routine. Which actually brings me into today's sponsorship.
Today's video is sponsored by Curology. Now, if you haven't heard of Curology before, I'm about to tell you. Curology is a custom skincare brand that's designed just for you. And a lot of you guys have asked me what my skincare routine is, and it's Curology. For the last 4 years or so, my skin was never really good. I always had acne right here, on my forehead. I had forehead wrinkles. I had super bad wrinkles on my forehead when I was like 17, 18 years old. And I would always be like, why do I have the wrinkles of an 80-year-old man when I'm 17 years old? And I felt like no matter what skincare I used, whatever I was trying, it didn't really seem to work. The acne right here, right here, and right here, it would always seem to come back. It would just never consistently go away. And then Curology came in the picture. My friend Alicia uses Curology, and her skin was always clear, and I was always like, why is your skin clear and not mine. And then she told me that she used Curology. And then Curology reached out to me and I was like, okay, yeah, I wanna try this. And I did. They sent me my first trial bottle and I started using Curology in about May of 2020. And I have proof too, I'll show you. All these Curology bags. As you can see, you can't even read what's on that bottle anymore because it's quite old. But I started using Curology almost about a year ago. And since I've used Curology, my skin has never been so consistently clear. My forehead wrinkles, gone. My acne around my chin area, gone. I started to look in the mirror and consistently noticed that my skin was always clear. And I was just like, wow, this has never happened before. It's never been this consistently clear. And it has stayed that way using Curology. And Curology is so easy. Because all I do is put on my custom formula that's made just for me on my face every single night before bed. Put some right here, right here, right here, right here, right here. Put some on my neck area. And then I go to sleep. It's literally that easy. And signing up for Curology is just that easy. All you have to do to sign up is take a little skin quiz, fill out your needs, what your skin type is, and then you take three little selfies. You take one this angle, one straight on, and then one on your right. Little selfie on every side so that they can see your skin. And once you send in your little skin quiz and your three selfies, a dermatology provider will go through your submission and then they'll prescribe you a custom formula just like this that is made just for you and your skin type. And then they'll send you a cute little box with this bag inside that comes with your nightly custom formula, has my name on it right there. And then it also comes with a pH balance cleanser and moisturizer. And if you click the link in my description, you can take your own little skin quiz, snap some selfies, and get your first month free. You just have to pay $4.95 for shipping and handling. So if you're struggling with acne, or even if your acne is not that bad and you just need a little something to keep your skin clear and feeling great, I recommend Curology. I really do. This little ball here has changed my skin. It has never been more consistently clear ever, besides when I was a little baby child. I definitely recommend joining the Curology Club. And once again, thank you, Curology, for sponsoring today's video. I snap out of staring myself in the mirror and begin to sniff my pits. Some mornings the odors are worse than others, but today it was totally fine. I smell pretty nice, I say with enjoyment. I obviously still put deodorant on anyways, because if I didn't, that wouldn't end up too good. After my morning bathroom activities are completed, I head back into my room to grab everything I need to make my grand appearance upstairs for the day. First, I grab my chapstick and apply more. I do this a lot during the day because if my lips are any amount near chapped, my whole vibe starts going into a downward spiral. I put my balm in my pocket. Zip! My sweat pocket says as I close it. I turn around and grab the hoodie that I've been wearing every single day and begin to put it on to keep the daily tradition going. It's just so soft, and once I get a new hoodie, I wear it completely out until I don't want to wear it ever again. I vigorously shake my body to make the t-shirt and hoodie even and comfortable, because if I don't do that, then I feel squirmy and awful. I then grab my essential water bottle and my phone and begin to make my ascent into the upstairs living room. I'm greeted by my cute cousin Charlotte, who we babysit every Thursday morning. On a normal morning, I would walk up and head straight to the couch. My mom would say, "Good afternoon," as if I had slept for 24 hours. Like, it's not even 10 a.m., Mom. God. "Hey," I say as I go to the couch I always sit on. But today, my couch sit is delayed because Charlotte's here. She's getting so big, wanting to move around everywhere and explore.
Charlotte, no. Hey, you can't go down here. You want to climb up?
Oh, I'm a big girl.
Oh, hi. Are you gonna make it? Hi.
She's like, okay, I wanna go back down.
Once I'm on my beloved couch, I do the exact same thing as in my bedroom. Just scroll and scroll with a side of casual conversation with my mother. As I sit, I begin to think about brunch. I never eat breakfast because I'm never up and ready to go during breakfast time. Brunch sounds cooler anyway. "Do you want anything from Joe's?" I ask my mom. I do this every morning in hopes that she wants something so I don't end up having to pay for myself. My mom can never make up her mind. "I don't know. Yeah, I guess so," my mom hesitates to say. As I'm thinking about a nice chai latte, Lottie is thinking about my essential water bottle. She could be entertained with this water bottle for hours on end. That's what's so good about babies. Then they learn how to walk and things decline from there. I go back to my room to grab my Joe's coffee shop essentials, my wallet — I decided to be a good person and pay today — my MWAH mask, my keys hanging back upstairs in the kitchen, and of course, my moccasins. Charlotte immediately crawls to me, and not because she's sad I'm leaving. Well, maybe. But mostly because she likes to untie the loops on my moccasins.
Oh, she wants to play with the strings.
I say goodbye to my mom and Lottie and turn around to my majestic mountain view to walk to my car.
Bye!
As the breeze courses through my hair, I grab the handle to open the door to my 1996 Toyota Camry named Betty. I named her Betty because it's a white car, Betty White's last name is White, and they're both old as shit, but somehow still thriving. As I turn my keys into the ignition to start my car, I begin to dial Joe's number to order a bagel, because if you want food and not just a drink, you have to call in advance. I turn my head away from my phone. I'm too poor to order food as well, I think to myself, but their bagels are so good. I dial the number and let it ring. No, I don't need it. I gasp as I turn away and hang up the phone. I breathe heavily. I'll just make avocado toast at home. I crank my gear shift into reverse and back out into my friendly neighborhood road to make my trek to Joe's coffee shop. I immediately start it every red light that comes in my way. I get very frustrated, but then I hit the old road with no stoplights for miles and start cruising.
You remember we were sitting there by the water. You put your arm around me for the first time.
The day is looking bright and I'm satisfied until I start to see orange signs scattered across the road, reminding me that there's construction ahead that's been lasting for weeks on end. Only one lane becomes available for driving, with construction workers telling me whether to stop or go slow. Sometimes you have to wait for like 10 minutes or more. I was not excited. But luckily, God was on my side this time, and I was able to go straight on through. Yeah, I laugh. Look at you losers, I get to go, and not you. I say enjoyably as I drive past all of the cars stopped in the other lane. Another red light. Will this terror ever end? I think to myself. Apparently it will. The light quickly turned green. Joe's Coffee Shop, the heart and soul of Payson, Utah. The only local coffee shop in town. And thankfully for me, there's not a long line today. I pull into the drive-thru, feeling the good vibes. Can I get a dirty chai with oat milk, a sugar-free vanilla latte with oat milk, and a raspberry chai with oat milk? All iced, I say to the barista. I decided to surprise my Aunt Amy with a drink as well when she drives to my house to pick up Charlotte. But I look at Find My Friends and realize Amy is quite close to my location, already on her way to my house. Am I gonna make it back in time? I say hesitantly. After not too long, the barista hands me my drinks and I drive away.
Thank you. You too.
I randomly gasp. I forgot to wear my mask. I croak. I roll my window up in defeat. I'm an idiot, I say in my Tom Holland head voice. I pull my mask out of my hoodie pocket and shake my head in disgust of myself. I've failed, I say as I fill my mouth with air, causing tension in my facial region. But then I remember I have an iced raspberry chai latte waiting for me to drink. My camera faints at the jealousy it feels as it watches me take a sip of my chai. Oh my God! I moan into the streets.
Wow!
I exclaim as I take another sip. I make my way back home, hoping that I beat Amy to my house, dodging idiotic drivers in my way. If I hit one more yellow light, I'm gonna crash this car. I say while pressing the gas pedal. Well, it looks like no one is getting their coffee because I'm crashing this car. I shake my head in disgust at the city stoplight system. The light finally turns green and I head to the freeway to drive in a construction-free zone. I cruise on the way back home while listening to my jams. And once I pull into my house, I realize I'd arrived before Amy. I cheer and head back inside as fast as possible. As I do, Amy pulls up in her white Lincoln. Hey, I shout as I awkwardly carry three drinks inside my home. I'm such an embarrassment, I think to myself. I struggle to get the front door open.
Hello?
I whelped to my mother in hopes of her opening the door. I made it inside and my Joe's trip was a success. Amy and Lottie left and my mom and I decide to make lunch. I take my cut avocado and start to mash it into guacamole, but it's a little rough as this avocado doesn't seem quite ripe enough yet. After mass pain occurs in both of my hands, I get the avocado to a spreadable point. I then add some red chili flakes and some salt and pepper, continued by popping some bread into the toaster so our avocado toast can be nice and crunchy. We had some leftover broccoli soup to join our avocado toast and what became our lunch. Me and my mom sit at the dining table to munch on our lunch as we catch up on the latest Riverdale episodes that we've missed. They flash 7 years forward into the future. How thrilling is that, right? As we watch this Oscar-worthy show, we devour our yummy soup and toast. We move to the living room to get a clearer view of this highly critical acclaimed television series. I sip on my chai, enjoying every single bit of it as I watch Betty Cooper go to therapy. Ooh, there's Jughead, I think to myself. I wish his character actually died when he faked his death or whatever. As we move through the fascinating 7-year time jump, I decided to go through and edit some photos that happened to be all from August of last year. My Instagram looks like shit right now and August was a hot month, so let's do a little August photo dump. I go through to ensure my photo order is how I aspire it to be, and then I share it to the world. How fun, right? Oh, hey, Miranda. I shout in my mind as Miss Cosgrove appears serving on my screen. I stay hydrated as this intense Riverdale episode keeps me off the edge of my seat. After 5 seasons, Barchi finally has a sex scene. Us Barchi stans have been waiting for this moment to arrive since Archie was just a simple musician whose only conflict was whether to pursue football or music. Wow, I say to the other voices in my head. Now they're having sex in the car. Then appears Jude, who's present during a sex scene on the television screen for some reason. We finish catching up on Riverdale and I head to my room to turn and realize that I have laundry to do. I have a flight to LA to catch and I can't just shove these dirty floor clothes into my suitcase like I would hope to. I move my suitcase over with my large foot and get to work. I don't have time to separate the whites and the darks for two separate loads because I'm running out of time. I grab my load of laundry and make my way to the laundry room across the hall from my bathroom. I gradually shove everything in the washing machine, pop open the cleanser drawer, scoop out my detergent, and dump it into the detergent box. I then press a few buttons to start the washing cycle and make my way outside because it is now my favorite part of the day. The part where I walk across the street to get the mail. My mail trip is when I feel most free with the world. I pop on a song and walk to that mailbox like I'm in a coming-of-age movie scene, because I am. I am that coming-of-age movie. I am the main character. Just like every day, I go to the mailbox hoping to open a compartment filled with packages for me. That rarely happens. I check through today's mail to see if my name is stamped across any envelopes, but not one appears. No mail for me, I say discouraged. I walk back into my home, shaking my head. I end my walking path in the bathroom, where I will now participate in my second favorite part of the day, shower time. I rip my clothing off my body and step over to the shower to start the water flow. People who get in the shower before starting the water are insane. I lick my speaker for suction and stick it to the shower wall for maximum volume. I then go through my phone sorting through my songs to make the perfect shower playlist. My song choices depend on what I'm feeling that day. Most days, my shower time is an EDM dance club concert in full force. Today is one of those days. I allow my music to start playing and feel the rhythm of whatever 2010's EDM song I'm playing that day. I fill my water to make sure it's just about hotter than Megan Fox. Not too much hotter, but just enough. And when it's at that level of hotness, I hop in. And the experience begins. I try not to let today's shower concert get too wild though, as I don't want to get my hair wet to redo it. I don't have time for that tonight. It's getting a little foggy, I gasp as the heat intensifies. I grab my loofah and drizzle my scented body wash all around, making sure every loofah flap is secured in the cleanser. I begin with my pits and make my way around as I hold a fake microphone in my hand, chatting to what is now That Kind of Woman by Dua Lipa playing. I flip my hair back and forth and the vibes course through every single vein of my being. I drain out all of the leftover soap in my loofah and continue to perform. My hair is starting to get wet from the humidity in the bathroom, but I don't care. I'm having too much of a good time. I turn the shower off, push the curtains open, and begin to dry off. I walk to my room in my cherry red towel and head straight for my vanilla chapstick, considering I haven't applied any in a minute. I stand around sighing. What do I wear? I shrug. I look around my room to get any inspiration of what my airport outfit will be. Airport outfits are important. You get to show a whole worldwide audience of what you have to offer. I chose to put on the exact same hoodie again. I can't believe I'm wearing shorts, I blurt out. Oh well, it's basically spring now, I continue to say. I then turn around to face my suitcase, which is not packed yet. I stressfully grab my hair knowing that I can't procrastinate on this any longer. I pull out my phone and check the time. It's almost 7 o'clock.
Oh no. I'm running out of time,
I state. I jump to the floor and get to packing. I was planning on leaving to the airport at 7, and here I squat next to my suitcase that isn't ready for takeoff. I was in Minnesota last, and I definitely won't be needing this winter coat in Florida and LA. I frantically toss my clothes from my last trip out of my suitcase. I continue to go through everything in my bag, mentally tossing or keeping each item for my next adventure. Beanies? Nah. I toss them out as I grab my tropical colored curved hat that I stole from Walmart and place it in my suitcase. I start to make progress as I fold more items into my bag. I open my shorts drawer that I haven't touched in months. I can't believe it's finally spring, I think to myself. I quickly sprint to the other side of my room to pack my backpack. I fill it with all my electronics equipment as I'm a working boy on the go. I congratulate myself for getting this far. I quickly snap out of it as I realize that I have more tasks to complete. I leap back to my suitcase and put my bright colored shorts next to my vintage jeans. I slowly put the pieces together as I fill more and more empty space. I transfer to my closet to grab any extra shirts I might want to tag along with me. Riverdale shirt? Absolutely, I think as I toss it next to my bag. I lastly grab my first ever MWAH t-shirt that you can get at MWAH.shop and throw it at my shirt pile. I fold the shirts into rectangular form and put them in their secured place. As I get closer to the finish line, I grab my essentials to make sure I don't forget them. I first grab my wallet because I've forgotten that a numerous amount amount of times. My chapstick, obviously, and my AirPods. A flight with no music is quite literally hell on earth. I last minute grab some swimsuits and shove them into my bag. I then run to the laundry room to grab my freshly dried clothes so I can throw any last minute apparel into my suitcase. The load dried just in time. It's like everything works out for me. How perfect is my life? I then grab my extra shoes from my closet floor. I probably won't work out, but I bring my running shoes with anyway, as well as some slides. I begin to sprint to the bathroom to grab my last minute item to complete my packing job.
Mom!
I yell from below.
Can you make me a big bowl with cheese? I'm almost unpacking.
My mom shouts. I make it to the bathroom and immediately spray my cologne and lather deodorant on my pits to ensure a great smell while at the airport. I spray my hair with coconut mist and attempt to fix what the shower party destroyed. I grab my hygienic bag and take one last look in the mirror. We did it. I pull back into my room and put my last item in my suitcase. As I close my bag, I start to think, wow, I accomplished last minute packing yet again. I'm amazing. I prop my suitcase up and begin to drag it up the stairs. I make my way into the kitchen to find a big bowl of macaroni hamburger and tomato juice made by my mother. You're probably confused by that name because I think my family is the only people on earth who call it macaroni hamburger and tomato juice. It's always been a favorite since I was a child. I begin to quickly shove spoonfuls in my mouth. I pause. Damn, my mom put a lot of cheese in this. I quickly continue to scarf down my dinner in literally 2 minutes. I amaze myself sometimes. I bring my empty stained bowl into the sink and give it a quick rinse before I head to the fridge to grab my mother and I some Red Bulls for the 1 hour trek to the airport. I notice the big pot of macaroni hamburger and tomato juice and shove a few extra bites in my mouth before saying goodbye to my other family members and heading out the door. As we back out the driveway, Jude gives us an extra special goodbye show. My mom and I's drive to the airport consists of Red Bull sipping and music jamming with a large side of road rage on my mom's end. I look out the window into the night. As the freeway lights beam across my face, I think of Tom Holland's message to me this morning. Tom, I grew up today by the balls. I hope you're proud. As the hour drive goes by, we get closer to our destination. I chug my watermelon Red Bull before I head inside, as there's no outside beverages allowed. As we get to the end of the road, I wave to my mom goodbye and check in for tonight's flight. I walk through the new Salt Lake City International Airport and am yet again amazed by the new features. The pretty inside never gets old. For a moment, I glance around the fresh airport to people watch. It's my favorite thing to do. Some people do very embarrassing things while they think no one's watching. Well, guess what, babe? I'm watching. I'm always watching. I make my way to security and pray everything goes smoothly. Oh my god. I say as my backpack moves to the right to be inspected. This, like, always happens. But there's nothing I can do because my backpack is just filled with all my electronics. I look at my boarding pass to realize I have to go to the B gates, which in this new airport is a long-ass walk away. I zip my front backpack pouch open to collect my AirPod Pros, pop them into my ears, and swipe to my music library to begin the most incredible airport walking movie scene of your life. Any time where I can dramatically be in a music video, I'm going to grab that opportunity in the ass, and I'm going to grab it hard.
Life's like a road that you travel on, one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened doorway, booze won't haunt you anymore.
7 minute walk to the B gates? No problem. My AirPod Pros have my back tonight. At least there's pretty wall decorations on this long walk, right? I think to myself. I get to that last escalator to finally make it to the B gates. My gate was really close by. I was the last one to board too. Not the most impressive last minute airport drive, but oh well. I'm still here. Thank God I got a window seat, I joyfully say to myself. I fidget around with my AirPod Pros to ensure maximum comfort. Considering I'm sitting in Comfort Plus, comfort is mandatory. I look out the window as we start to back out of our gate. It's almost time for my destination to Orange County to begin. As I wait, I connect to the free internet with a certain major CEO's help, but that's a secret I'll never tell. Let's see what TikTok has to offer me, I scroll. Oh my God, it's Glozell! I scream. I haven't seen her in years. I immediately double tap. The plane slowly moves through the runway as it suddenly becomes to a halt. We're next in line to take off. I quickly scroll to the Bluetooth app to make sure my AirPod Pros are in noise cancellation mode. Yep, looks like they are. I want to hear nothing but my music and extremely unnecessary random thoughts. I look back out of my window and start to feel the anticipation rise. The air from above my seat blows slightly onto my face. As I feel the cold breeze, my feet start to tap rhythmically. This is the moment. We'll be taking off any minute now. The plane proceeds to go forward and the vibes begin to rise. The inside of my body shouts to the universe and the universe takes it all in. The plane begins to reach a faster speed every millisecond. I feel every atom, every fiber of the good vibes go through my body inch by inch. Speed's increasing on the runway. This is it. The moment every soul on this aircraft has been waiting for. The plane starts to defy gravity. I start levitating. It happened. The plane took off into the sky, making its ascent in Orange County. As the plane gets higher and higher, I begin to see more and more lights brighten the horizon below me. I'm at peace. The plane begins to descend into California as new lights from a new city with new faces, new dreams appear. I've made it to my destination. As the plane arrives to the gate, I unbuckle my seatbelt and text Hunter that I've officially landed. He reads it and doesn't reply like usual. I walk towards baggage claim to find my white suitcase waiting for me. I pick it up and make my way outside to wait for my personal Uber driver to pick me up. Hunter pulls up to the curb in his red car while blasting Taylor Swift's new version of Love Story. I hop into the car and assure my mom that I have arrived safely. We make our way through the parking garage and into Hunter's apartment. I kick my shoes off and take a deep sigh of relief until I look over and see that the bowl of oatmeal Hunter was making exploded in the microwave. After Hunter's failed attempt to clean it, he decides to simply put another bowl around the mess. He starts breaking out even chunks of banana to garnish the oatmeal, followed by some strawberries.
You got strawberries too?
I say shockingly.
Mm-hmm. No, you can't.
Hunter douchingly replies.
I didn't ask.
I timidly respond. As he begins cutting the strawberry, the sliced fruit went directly onto the floor instead of the bowl.
I cut myself yesterday doing this. That was great.
He continues slicing the berry into the oatmeal and throws his fruit scraps into the filled dirty sink instead of the trash can behind him. He repeats this action twice and finishes off by throwing the knife directly my way. As the night comes to an end, I grab my Curology and apply it to my face before I go to sleep after this long, productive day, because I want to continue waking up with clear skin, thanks to Curology. I head to the fridge to grab a Capri Sun juice pouch and a bottle of water to set on my nightstand. I take my socks off right before I slide into bed because people who sleep with their socks on are psychotic. I move to my lamp to flip the switch off. I then squeeze my Capri Sun until every drop of liquid has made it into my mouth. I set it aside to then doze off and refresh myself to do it all again tomorrow.